Our summer break coming up. So welcome to Splash, everybody. My name is Dr. H2O, but you can call me Dr. Jim. H2O, does anybody know what H2O stands for? Everybody said it once.
Water!
You are exactly correct. Yes, the water, but it is definitely the atom of oxygen. Two H's. So we are probably going to be talking to you about water. Would that be a good guess?
Yeah.
You're correct. And more so, we're going to be talking to you about something that lives in the water. Its name is the Gambusia fish. Can you everybody say Gambusia?
Gambusia!
Very good, very good. Now the Gambusia have a nickname. Does anybody here have any idea of what that nickname might be? Yes? It isn't Gambu. And it isn't boozy. What's that? Jumping fish, good guess. Penny fish, good guess. And actually, it should be in your little paper right there. It says it. They have another name. And it's not the scientific name. It's the other fish. It is the mosquito fish.
Oh, yeah!
They're called the mosquito fish, and why do you think they're called the mosquito fish? Yes!
Because they eat mosquito eggs.
Good job, Dr. Nate. And good guess, Dr. Gabby's like, how'd you know my name? I love it when you guys have tags, because then I can pretend like I know you. So, you guys are all going to be, I noticed I called him Dr. Nate. You guys are all going to be doctors of science today. You're going to be scientists. And you're going to be helping us solve a mystery. Now, this is how it goes. Gambusia fish eat mosquitoes, right? Mosquito eggs. And do we like mosquitoes?
No,
we don't like mosquitoes. Because number one, mosquitoes, they have diseases, but they bite us. And then they suck our blood. And then after they're done sucking their blood, they... Exactly, their saliva makes a bump in our skin that itches. And then a lot of times we could maybe catch a disease from them after they bite us and suck our blood. So we don't like them very much. Now, there's a couple of different kinds of diseases that you could get, a bunch of different kinds of diseases you can get from mosquitoes. The main one is malaria.
Check.
So that's good to know. Now we used to have a malaria in this state, but what the scientists and the government and their scientists decided to do was, since mosquitoes lay their eggs in still bodies of water, they tried to empty all the water from all the lakes and all the marshes they crossed. But of course, as you probably can figure out, they can't empty all the water from all the lakes. So anything that was left over, they took poison chemically called all open waters that were left, and that definitely killed the mosquitoes. But what else do you think it might have killed? Yes? The fish and the animals that lived in the ponds. Good job, Dr. McKenna. Anything else? They definitely killed some Gambusia fish. And yes, Dr. Riggs, they killed some plants. And the main thing that it did too, after killing certain animals that came and drank from the water, animals that lived in the water, some of the poison wasn't strong enough to kill them, but what it did was it went into their bodies, made them kind of sick, but they survived, but the poison was now in their bodies. Now then, when eagles, like the golden eagle and the bald eagle, came down and grabbed fish to eat and ate the fish, and
the poison from the fish went into the babies and the mama's bodies, and it changed their metabolism, changed their bodies, and then when they started laying eggs, their shells were very, very thin. And when mama and dada eagle would go sit down on the eggs to keep them warm and incubate them, the egg shells would crack. And so we almost lost the golden eagle, almost lost the bald eagle because of that. Now, luckily, they're making a return, a comeback, and hopefully they're going to be doing good for a lot of years. But do you think that was a very good idea to be spraying the poison all over the water like that? No, I don't think so either. So luckily, somebody found out about the Gambusia fish and the fact that Gambusia fish eat the mosquitoes' eggs. And so now, if you go to the health department in San Diego and you tell them, I live here, that we're having mosquito problems, or a lot of people in San Diego have problems. So they can say, I have a lot of property and we have mosquito problems. They, at the health department, will give you a bag full of Gambusia fish. Put those in the pond, they eat the mosquito eggs, and we have less mosquitoes. So, sounds great, right? Only problem is, and this is where your part comes in, to solve the mystery. Scientists solve mysteries using their different tests and research and so on. There is a pond near where we used to know they had, we used to go have picnics there and so on. They had lots of Gambusia in the pond. We could see them. They were living happy, healthy lives. Now we can't find one Gambusia in the pond. In fact, I don't think we've even found any other living things in that pond for a while. And so hopefully what you guys are going to do is help do some research, and maybe we can find out the mystery of the disappearing Gambusia. Sound good to you guys?
Yes.
Yes. One more time. Does sound good to you guys?
Yes.
That's what I want to hear. Kids make it some noise. So good. We're going to split up into our teams. And we're going to start doing our research. Then we'll get back together real quick. And we'll discuss what we found. Maybe we can find a solution. So let's start with microscope team, green team.
Green team.
Green team. Okay, you guys go to the door of the splash lab and you will be given directions. And then let's see, aquifer team, light blue team. Oh, awesome. You guys will all be with our very right over here. And then let's see, how about dark blue team, light around the pond. Awesome. Put on your lamp post, grab yourselves a clipboard. And let's see, who else? The orange team, storm drain team. Awesome, you guys will be right over there with Dr. Kelly. Please over to the orange